And submission is better than offering the fat of rams. Rebellion is as sinful as witchcraft, and stubbornness as bad as worshipping idols. So because you have rejected the command of the Lord, he has rejected you as king. God did not come down from heaven and appeal to King Saul and gave him commandment. God sent Prophet Samuel, like he is sending us every Sunday, and to most of us leaders, yet for disobeying the commandment of God from the mouth of the servants of God. His glorious kingdom as the first king of over Israel was taken from him and given to someone else ready to obey and please God. And this is also a direct warning and prophecy for all of us leaders that are entrusted to various positions in the Church of Christ. God is no respecter of anybody. If King Saul could be replaced as king over Israel for failing to follow God's commandment, God can also conveniently replace any leader found wanting and find more dedicated and committed leaders to serve him in this vineyard. If only we can understand and appreciate what a glorious privilege we have to be a worker in the vineyard of Christ than being a noble in the palace of Satan. Disobedience leads to sin and death. The disobedience of Adam brought sin and death into the world. But Christ's perfect obedience restores our fellowship with God for everyone who believes in him. Amen. As we get to read in Romans 5:19, explain it thus: for as by one man's, that's Adam's disobedience, the many were made sinners, so by one man's, Christ's obedience, the many will be made righteous. Yeah. And then in 1 Corinthians 15, 22-23, by now, having been freed from sin and enslaved to God, you derive your benefit resulting in sanctification. And the outcome, eternal life. For the wages of sin is death. Yes. But the free gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Through obedience, we experience the blessing of holy living.
Amen.
Through obedience, we experience the benefit of holy living. Only Jesus Christ is perfect.
Yeah.
Therefore, only he could walk in sinless obedience.
Glory.
But as we allow the Holy Spirit to transform us from within, we grow in holiness.
Amen.
So in Psalm 119, 1-8, joyful are people of integrity who follow the instructions of the Lord. Joyful are those who obey his laws and search for him with all their hearts. They do not compromise with evil, and they walk only in his path. You have charged us to keep your commandments carefully. Oh, that my actions will consistently reflect your decree. Then I will not be ashamed when I compare my life with your commands. As I learn your righteous regulations, I will thank you by living as I should. I will obey your decree. Please, don't give up on me. Amen.
Amen.
And also in Isaiah 48:17-19, this is what the Lord says. Your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel, I am the Lord your God, who teaches you what is good for you and leads you along the path you should follow. Oh, that you had listened to my commands, then you will have had peace flowing like a gentle river and righteousness rolling over you like waters or like waves in the sea. Your descendants will have been like the sands along the seashore, too many to count. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There will have been no need for your destruction or for cutting off your family name. And also in 2 Corinthians 7:1, because we have these promises, dear friends, let us cleanse ourselves from everything that can defile our body or spirit.
Amen.
And let us walk towards complete holiness because we fear God.
Amen.
The verse above says, let us walk towards complete holiness. So we don't learn obedience overnight. It's a lifelong process that we pursue by making it a daily goal.
Amen.
As we have been told that there is time for everything, the time for total obedience for all of us And most especially all leaders in the church is now.
Amen.
If our prayers to move forward is to be accomplished, the wall of Jericho was not pulled down without total obedience, which required trust, belief in the leadership, and willingness to support and execute the directives of the leader. Joshua was assured by all the leaders of Israel that after he succeeded Moses as leader, as we also read in Joshua 1:16-18, and they answered Joshua saying, all that thou hast commanded us we will do, and whithersoever thou sent us we will go. According as we hearken unto Moses in all things, so we will hearken unto thee. Only the Lord thy God be with thee, as he was with Moses. Whosoever he be that doeth rebel against thy commandment, and will not hearken unto thy words in all that thou commandest him, he shall be put to death. Only be strong and of good courage.
Amen.
Amen. Be strong and of good courage. We have not all been chosen by accident. Let me repeat it. We have not all been chosen by accident, but by grace, which we have received in Christ Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
And it is most important, as chosen by grace, not to be like the fig tree, which refused to bear fruit, as Christ told us in John 15:1-2, I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine dresser. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away. And every branch that bears fruit, he prunes it so that it may bear more fruit. You are already clean because of the word which I have spoken to you. We all need prayers.
Amen.
As no one is free from falling. Moses was well prepared for his mission. But at the end, he failed to accomplish his task and had to be replaced by Joshua. King Solomon was well favored and bestowed with wisdom, wealth, power, and good understanding. And yet he was forsaken by God towards the end of his reign over Israel. Just as Prophet Eli was rejected by God. And this is why Apostle Paul appealed to the leaders in 1 Timothy 2:1-3. I urge then, first of all, that petitions, prayers, intercession, and thanksgiving be made for all people, for kings, and all those in authority, that we may live peaceful and quiet lives in all goodness and holiness. This is good and pleases God our Savior. All leaders, we need prayer.
Amen.
I pray the Almighty God to give us more hearts of understanding and spirit of submission to the will of God, which will enable us to develop the virtue of obedience to the will of God and his servant. I pray to God to bless us all and count us among the favored ones that we reach our Canaan land. We have work to do.
Amen.
And we have obligations to fulfill. And God will make a way where there is no way for us, as long as we set our hearts to trusting and loving Christ and pleasing him.
Amen.
We will not perish like the rebellious children of Israel in the wilderness, who started the journey all the way from Egypt, only to end up in the wilderness without getting to their promised land. And that is why we have to jointly read the Bible this morning. Can we all please open our Bible to Romans chapter 12? That is our sermon this morning. Romans chapter 12, verses 1. Romans chapter 12.
So you start the sermon.
Please open your Bibles to Romans chapter 12. Romans chapter 12.
No,
are you all there?
I ain't tired right now. Mm-hmm. I'm about to turn this thing off. I ain't tired.
Therefore, I urge you, brethren, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as living and holy sacrifice, acceptable to God, which is your spiritual service of worship. And do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, so that you may prove what the will of God is, that which is good and acceptable and perfect. But through the grace given to me, I say to